Hi everyone, welcome back to another week of high school. I'm your host, Raven Austin, and today we have some pretty cool things to share. First up, we have Kyle Finley with a Texas montage.
Shake me down. Not a lot of people left around. Who knows now? Softly laying on the ground. Ooh. Not a lot of people left around. Ooh. In my life, I've seen people walk into the sea just to find memories plagued by constant misery. Thrice cast down, fixed upon the ground. Thrice cast down.
All right, awesome video, Kyle. I didn't know Texas was so pretty. Up next, we have Brett Jones with a spicy PSA video.
Hello, my name is J.K. Bob. I would like to present you with a public service announcement in response to the death of a beloved friend, Timmy, my goldfish. In my grief since Tommy's tragic death, I came to realize the injustice of nature and the world around us. See, Timmy, my goldfish, never had access to the great wonders of the world. And if he had access to the great human technological advances, perhaps he'd still be alive. Excuse me, I apologize. I figure that we humans should know how to lead long and happy lives, unlike my fish, Tommy. So I am here to provide you with three simple technologies that are essential to happy, sustainable lives. Three things that I wish my poor Tommy could have experienced. First, the toothbrush. The toothbrush is humanity's most efficient cleaning utensil. Not only does the toothbrush have the ability to clean teeth, but it can also clean the body, valued possessions, and the soul. I typically weep with mine for hours as a form of therapy. Second, the cell phone. Not only does the cell phone allow for interstellar communication, but endless amounts of entertainment and knowledge to satisfy the brain. Though beware, obtaining reception can be a dangerous affair. Third and finally, the pen. The pen can be used to record any and all information and communicate with others in your travels. Actually, it's quite similar to the cell phone, so you could really get rid of this one. Although it does serve as a nice alternative to self-defense. In memory of my dear departed friend, Timmy, the goldfish. I provide you with this public service announcement to show you just how lucky you are as human beings and how you can lead long and happy lives. Unfortunately, my goldfish wasn't as lucky and didn't survive. I hope this will help. Goodbye. Is that it?
Wow, heroing video, Brett. Up next, we have Amanda and Maggie Smith with a Lizard Moving Day montage.
Is that all you get for your money? And it seems such a waste of time. If that's what it's all about, Mama, if that's moving up, then I'm moving out.
What a cold-blooded video, Amanda and Maggie. Now, I'm gonna pass it off to Brett with sports.
Hey, it's a sports segment. My name is Brett Jones. Let's hit this thing. Sports are back. We got some spring stuff, so let's hit it. First up, we got track. We got some first-place finishers, and Nyla Stokes did pole vault. Mick had a high jump and 200-meter dash. Way to go there. Adrian Brown in the 110-meter hurdles. Megan ran the 800 meter and got first, and Jonathan Jones also got first in the 3,200 meter, along with a host of other top three finishers. That is a lot of people. That's a lot of names. That's a lot of first places. As a team, the boys placed first overall, and the girls placed second overall. That is phenomenal. Now, we have boys tennis. They had a tourney in Emporia. Jared Bowman placed sixth, and Clayton Simmons placed ninth. Way to go to those folks. Now, we have some baseball and softball. Baseball played Andover Central and split the double header. I can speak English, I promise. We won one of them and lost the other one. Softball played the same team and beat them 8-6. They also beat Wichita Northwest 16-15. That is a lot of points. We also have soccer. Our girls' soccer team beat Wichita East in the Titan Classic Tournament. They followed that with a tight loss to Mays and another one to Capen, taking fourth in the tournament. That is solid. Finally, we have some girls swimming. The girls took second overall in their first meet in El Dorado. They also went to the Wichita Heights Invitational and placed sixth. That is awesome. That's a lot of sports, but guess what? We have one more winter sport to cover, and that is bowling. Bowling season is over, but we do have a highlight video of the home triangular. There's a lot of like English words that I'm just not really used to saying, like of and a, so it's like really confusing right now. So let's just go to visual, not audio stuff like my speaking, and let's check out a bowling highlight video. Let's go.
Thank you for tuning in today. Make sure to follow us on Twitter at DTV260 and Snapchat at DHS Broadcast. Do not forget to like and subscribe to us on YouTube. And finally, don't forget that it's always a great day to be a Panther. Again, thank you for watching.